Oh boy.
So watch.
So I was just going to say, where's the camera? And it's that big thing in the middle of the room.
Time starts now. All right. Let me put this down. All right. So the first game is for no points. It's just for introductions. And the game is called They've Got Issues. And it's a game where I'm going to name a superhero, and my panelists, in the rules apply to The Price is Right, will have to guess how many appearances, how many issues those characters have appeared in over the course of their career. This information is from comicvine.com, which is a website sort of wiki situation where people keep track of this stuff. Now, it does include, the numbers include reprints and some foreign editions, so it's not an exact number, but again, closest without going over. You guys understand the game?
Yeah.
All right. Fantastic. So the superhero we're going to play, we're going to start with, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to name the superhero, and then we're going to go to each of you, and we're going to introduce you as we move down the line. Does that make sense?
Mm-hmm.
Terrific. The superhero we're talking about today is Daredevil. How many issues has Daredevil appeared in? Daredevil, Secret Identity Matt Murdock, the blind superhero, wears all red, horns on his head. That rhymed. That was it was great. That was not intended. That was magic. That was the magic of
all night working on that. Don't tell me that was something that just came out.
I will admit when it's something that I worked on. That was off the top. So Brad, evilinc.com, webcomics handbook, how to make webcomics, talented fellow, terrific, maybe the best voice in this room.
Possibly maybe the earlier best, this weekend it was.
Possibly the best voice in this building. How many issues?
I'm going to say 2,500.
All right. 2,500. Chris Giarusso, creator of G-Man from Image Comics, possibly the best superhero comic in this building. Sitting next to me in the convention floor, on the convention floor. How many comics, how many issues has Daredevil appeared in?
3,000.
3,000. Jay Faerber. The guy who I drew your very first comic book?
Mm-hmm.
Noble Causes, Dynamo 5, Near Death. You write for Star-Crossed on the WB. Writer Extraordinary. How many comics has Daredevil appeared in?
And just so I understand, the we're not just books with his name.
No,
like any comic.
Any comic. So when he showed up in Spider-Man, somebody that wikied that. Yeah.
Including reprints? Right.
Reprints and foreign editions. Again, according to this comicvine.com wiki situation. Crowdsourced.
3,800.
3,800.
I've got a wiki situation.
Keep it clean.
All right. Chris, you win. 3,133 appearances. All right, so I don't know where the other two are, so we're just going to keep playing the game. Are there any comic creators in the crowd that want to step up? All right, fine. Jay, we're going to start with you. Who in the crowd wants to play? Jay, please choose a partner from the crowd. The gentleman with the beard, what is your name?
Matt.
Two T's? All right.
Nope.
All right. Chris.
Every time the door opens, everyone's going to go.
This guy here.
Your name, sir?
Ray.
Ray. You were at the panel 2 years ago and you were wearing a scary mask, correct? I remember you.
Not wearing it this weekend because I can't find it.
Oh, no.
So that's not a mask.
Brad?
Spider-Man hat in the back.
Spider-Man hand in the back. What is your name?
Rowan.
Rowan. All right. R-O-H-A-N?
R-O-W-A-N.
Named W-A-N. After the funny half of the Laugh-In duo, am I right?
Mr.
Bean.
Ah.
That was my second guess.
All right, so you guys now have your partners. You guys will come into play a little bit later, and you'll come up here and talk into this microphone. It's going to be great. The next game we're going to play, and Maris and Joe are missing out. They are.
Spoken like a mom. They're missing out. I'm disappointed in them.
I am disappointed in them. Maris was so excited. I don't know where she is. The next game is called Alphabet Superheroes. And this I thought of this morning. the name is based on Alphabet Soup, which I don't even know if that's a thing anymore, is it? Alphabet Soup? You have children, Brad.
They do have Alphabet Soup, but now they've updated it. You only get 140 of them in there.
Only 140 letters.
Only 140 characters.
Ah.
See how I did that? And that was done right here, ladies and gentlemen. You can take that to the bank.
The follow-up is, do they still make Alphabits cereal?
Ooh.
Because that, no? Yes?
You mean that?
What's that? All right.
You mean that horribly tasting all-sugar cereal? I'd be surprised if they don't still make that.
Isn't it just Cheerios shaped like letters?
I thought so.
Yeah.
No, it's drenched in sugar.
Come on up. How about a hand for Magical Maris Wicks?
I promise Joe's coming.
All right. Well, Maris, the first thing you need to do, anyone wants to play, raise your hands. Choose somebody from the crowd as your partner.
Golly.
You're leaping into the fire.
Yeah, man. All the way in the back with a red hat.
What is your name, young man?
Martin.
Ian?
Ian, nice to meet you. I'm Maris. I promise I will play very well for you.
All right, so far, Maris, the only game you missed was They Have Issues, and it was for no points.
Oh,
phew. It was the Price is Right style.
For no points, and I won.
Congratulations, sir.
So now we're about to play Alphabet Superheroes. You missed a great bit of business about Alphabet Soup and Alphabits.
Okay, I like both of those things. But not together.
Not at the same time.
Yeah, no, gross. No marshmallows in my soup, please.
The way this game works is we're going down the alphabet, and we're going down the row, and you name a superhero that starts with the letter of the alphabet.
Okay.
It's elimination style. If you can't do it in like 3 to 5 seconds, you're out.
Okay.
Points are accrued the longer you last. So whoever is there at the end gets 4 points. Et cetera, et cetera. Superheroes only. No supervillains. This is a super friends panel. Positive energy. We're going to start now with Chris, since we started with you before.
Right? Oh, I see what you're doing.
Yeah. So, Chris, I need a and the other part of this is I have a list of 26 superheroes. One
Chris
for
looked
each
at
letter.
The list.
What's it?
Chris looked at the list.
He didn't. I've kept it from him.
I saw him look. Just kidding.
26 superheroes, A through Z. If you match one of mine, you get an extra point. Yeah. And there's very little rhyme or reason to this list of 26. We're going to go around and around. So if we get to Z, we keep going. And we'll see how long this might eat up the full 50 minutes. Or we've done this once before, and it lasted all of 3 minutes. So, Chris, A.
Aztec.
Oh, that's a good one.
And am I A or B?
You're B.
I'm B. Batman.
Captain Marvel.
Daredevil.
Elephant Steve.
That's a good one. Elephant Steve is great.
Flash.
Oh.
G.
Oh. Guardians of the Galaxy, does that count? If they're
I'll give it to you. Brad.
A whole bunch of them.
H.
Hal Jordan.
All right.
Oh, you.
Oh yeah, you yes. didn't have a better one.
Especially with the Green Lantern, it's sort of.
All right.
You know.
Okay.
I need an I, Chris.
Oh no.
Five.
Oh no.
Four. Three.
Invincible.
All right. J. I need a J.
Oh man,
this is gonna come as no surprise to you, Jack of Hearts.
That it is not a surprise to me at all. J loves the Jack of Hearts, Maris.
Does Kamani count? Is that okay? He's kind of like super boy.
It's a good
creature.
Question.
I know. He's really cool.
He's an adventure character.
I know. He was in Wednesday Comics.
Is Kamani a superhero? Crowd.
Kamani? He's like, yeah!
All right.
Deep cuts first.
Brad, I need an L.
Luke Cage.
All right. M.
Save me, Joe.
Come on up.
Yeah,
Joe was in the house. He did an M.
Martian Manhunter.
There you go.
Nova.
Nova.
Orion? Is there an Orion?
Yeah, yeah.
Orion.
Joe, I need you to name a superhero that starts with P.
Alphabet game.
Power Girl.
All right.
Hi.
Q.
Quasar.
Quasar, and you get an extra point. R.
Red Raven.
Red Raven?
Yeah.
Who's Red Raven?
Defenders.
Okay. Sorry. All right.
You worked at Marvel.
And you call yourself a game show host.
Right, listen, I don't have all the answers.
Revoort would be disappointed.
He might be. S.
Superman.
Superman, sure. T.
I'm going to go Tatiana, Colossus' sister. Is that okay? Or is it just like, Yeah. Oh, no, that's, yeah. Oh, no. Oh. Okay, let me do this thing here.
Okay.
you know, Tawny Tiger?
Now, he has a full name.
What?
Yeah, there's a word before a Tawny Tiger.
Oh, man.
Five.
I need a paper bag to hyperventilate.
Three. Two.
Tara Strong?
Who's Tara Strong?
Oh, yeah. Man, my brain is just a hot mess right now.
I might have to eliminate you, Maris.
You can eliminate me. That's cool.
Maris, you're out. I'm sorry.
Now, does it go on or does the game end?
Oh, it keeps going. It's elimination style. So, nice. Joe.
Make you proud, Joe.
I need a T.
T.
oh, my goodness.
It's hard, right? I know there's a T out there.
Wait, all right, hold on. Why can't I think of a T?
Are we going to be a get out power couple?
Is it only superheroes?
Yes.
Darn it. Okay.
Hal Jordan was said earlier, so if you have a name of a superhero.
Oh, okay. Oh, Tony Stark.
Okay.
I can do that?
That'll work.
All right, sweet.
You.
I was over here queued up for Thor.
Yeah.
it's hard under the spotlight.
Oh, I know.
It is.
I know, because now I've got you and I got nothing. Ultraman.
There you go.
I didn't know there was a such thing
there
as
is.
Ultraman.
There is an Ultraman.
Venture.
Ah, nice. That's a Jay Faerber character.
And Jamal Igel. Wonder Woman.
Wonder Woman, very good. Joe, I need an X.
What?
Oh, Joe's out? No. He said Tony Stark. Maris is out. Now Maris is eliminated. Maris has 0 points right now.
X-Man?
Magical Maris.
X-Man? Is that a person?
X-Man is a person, and you get a bonus point.
Wow.
Because not a lot of X characters, guys. There are others. I need a Y.
Yellow Jacket.
Very good. Chris, I need a Z.
Me too.
Five, four, three, two.
Zim? Invader Zim?
Invader Zim?
Zim? The Zim
Vader
count?
Zim is not a superhero. I'm calling the shot on that one. You are eliminated. Jay Faerber.
Zenith.
Interesting. It's interesting, especially interesting because the Z I have here is connected to you, sir. Think about it.
Oh, yeah.
All right. We're starting the alphabet over. Joe, I need an A.
Animal Man.
All right. I need a B.
Beast.
Beast is great, but he's not on my list.
Colossus.
We are running through the X-Men.
Deadpool.
Deadpool. E.
E-Man. Oh, don't laugh. He exists.
E-Man? there's like an independent web.
State,
yeah, Joe Staten thing.
Yeah. Firestar.
Firestar. G.
Giant Man.
Giant Man is a superhero.
Nice. Don't worry about it.
H? How about an H, Brad?
Man, my ego will not prevent me from saying Captain Heroic.
But that starts with a C, man.
Heroic starts with an H.
Yeah, but...
I think you mean heroic comma cat.
Yeah.
Exactly.
H, yeah.
Hellcat from the Defenders.
There you go. Hellcat from the Defenders.
Iceman.
All right. I need a J.
Joanna Man? No.
That's a hilarious movie. I've never seen it.
Why can't I think of a J?
Yeah, it's a good question.
It's a good question.
Jack of Hearts has already been said. Five, four, three.
That's not helping.
Two. Joe, you're right. Out. Sorry. Brad, it's I need okay. a J.
Man, I'm coming up with all the great villains. I've got Juggernaut and Joker.
And the Juice Man is not a superhero. He just makes juice. He's just an old man who drinks a lot of juice.
I'm getting J. Jonah Jameson, but he's not a superhero.
He's not a superhero. I'm going to start. We are at five, four, three, two, one.
Jarvis. He made a great cup of tea.
He did make a great cup of tea, but he's not a superhero.
And there was that time that he used his silver tray as a shield.
I'm sorry, he's supporting cast.
Don't tell me later.
Can you win this thing with a J?
Jaguar.
Boom, from the Red Circle line of comics. Well done.
Woo. Who were you trying to telepathically send to me? Jubilee.
My J was Jaina from the Wonder Twins.
Oh, nice.
Zan and.
Oh, and a Z, too.
Yes, Z is, yeah. Nice. Well done, everybody. You Marissa, had something, Maris. You
she
were,
kept mouthing Jean Grey to me.
I know. Well, we were both out, so it's okay.
Yeah, that's fair. I just saw you were very excited.
I did get points, though, right? You said I got zero
points.
Yeah, points.
You got one.
I got no Kamani.
Chris
Kamani
has
and
two.
Guardians of the Galaxy. I'm keeping track up here. So I
have
two
points. You don't get which one. Whoever lasts the longest gets the most points. You got a point. Chris got 2 points. Joe got 3 points plus one.
Oh.
Bam.
For saying X-Man.
Yeah.
Brad got 4 plus 1 for saying Quasar. So he's at 5. And Jay has 5 because he was the last man standing.
Interesting.
Yet I want more points.
Oh, no. It's an accumulation of points. So we're going to keep adding up points.
Oh, I see.
Yeah. Okay. This next game is called Name That Story Arc. I also call this game the impossible game because it's not that easy unless you have like a Rain Man capability of knowing stories and titles.
We're done.
So here's how this works. I have 19 story arcs on these pages. You'll give me a number. I'll give you some clues. How many titles are in that story arc, individual story titles, and how many creators worked on it. You will then bid how many titles you'll need to name the overall arc. And if you think you know it, you can go negative, which is naming creators. So if you say, like, I know that story, and I can name 2 creators, you can bid that way. And I have the lists of creators and everything. And some of these have a lot of creators. And those creators include editors in some cases.
So you're just looking for creators on the arc and the title of the arc.
Well, I just want the title of the arc, unless you start bidding negative.
Okay.
If you're negative, creators. It can be anyone involved?
Yeah, not in order.
Yeah, not in order.
Okay.
Yeah.
Not
so
the masthead.
Like if you think you know it,
right.
Let's say you think it's like, oh, it's Watchmen. I know it's Watchmen. It's not going to be Watchmen. If you think you know it's Watchmen, you say, I know it's Watchmen. I could do I could do 2 creators.
Okay.
And then I'll say, okay, name the arc and the creators. And you'll say Watchmen and Alan Moore, Dave Gibbons. Unless you go deeper than that, I can't. Who lettered that? Anyone? Gibbons lettered himself, right?
I think so.
Maybe. Anyway, it doesn't matter. That's not one of the answers. Yeah, that's right. Thank you, Chris. Joe, you need to pick somebody in the crowd to play for. Who wants to play? Hands up.
Let's see. People are pointing at this person, so I'm going to follow their lead. With a red hat.
Red pigtails. Your name. Your name, young lady.
Cheryl.
C or S?
C.
All right.
Do we get buzzers or we just pound on the table furiously when we know the answer?
Oh, we're gonna start with Jay,
okay.
And we're gonna bid accordingly.
I wanted to pound on the table.
So Jay, everybody's gonna we're gonna start with everybody at one point. There's gonna be 5 rounds of this. Jay, Choose a number between 1 and 19.
19.
19. I had a feeling that was going to happen. All right, here we go. Here are the clues. It's a 12-part story taking place in its own series. So it's a self-contained series. There were tie-ins across this comic book universe to this 12-part series. It was inspired by something outside of comics, per se. It's a series beloved by some and reviled by others, but the events in this series were reflected in the main titles for those characters and have had lasting effects, one in particular. There was a 2010 miniseries exploring the event again from a specific character's point of view. There are 12 titles and 13 credits. What is your bid? You can the widest bid you can do is 12 titles. Or you might know it.
I think I know it.
Oh my! So you're saying zero?
Yeah, I'll say zero. Secret Wars.
What? Don't say anything until the next person.
Oh!
Bids.
I didn't know that. All right, sorry.
Maris, it's a flub. It happens. Maris, do you think you know it?
No.
No. Okay, so you're gonna say to Jay, name that story arc.
Yeah, I gotta say name it. I mean, I know you already kind of.
Jay, what is the story arc?
Secret Wars.
You are correct. Marvel superheroes, Secret Wars. Jay gets the points. All right.
12 issues.
12 issues. Yeah,
man.
Of maxi series. 12 issue maxi series.
That's absolutely right.
It was Spider-Man and the Secret Wars, where it retold the story. It was like focused on Spider-Man and how he felt about it.
And there was also Secret Wars 2, where the Beyonder had the Jerry curl. Yeah.
Yes, there was the Secret Wars 2.
There was also a landmark issue of What If.
There was a landmark issue of What If, that's true, that Jay and I worked on that explored the Secret Wars 20 years later. Yeah. We're the best.
We
are. Maris, a number between 1 and 19, but not 19.
13.
13. Lucky 13. Oh, this was, okay.
I just like prime numbers.
This is a self-contained miniseries of 4 issues. It's about a group of replacements and the original team that is unhappy about their replacements. It revived and reintroduced characters long forgotten. It should have gotten more attention and credit. There are 4 titles, 7 credits. These are very vague clues. The only other clue I can give might give it away to other panelists. So
okay.
That's what I'm giving.
So when you say 4 titles, you said 4 issues.
Four issues, yeah. 4 story titles.
Titles are the same thing as issues, so there's just 4
Each
issues.
Each issue had a
comic.
Different story title.
People replacing
There's a group that is replaced, and the original group is unhappy with their replacements. I can tell you this came out in 2009 into 2010.
Replacements. Oh, man.
Say 4 titles.
4 titles? What?
Like, you could say 4 titles, and then we could go, the bidding can...
Oh.
Unless you think you
okay,
know.
Okay, yeah, no, 4 titles. I like indie stuff, so I'm crossing my fingers for some deep-cut mini-comics.
Three.
Brad?
No, I have no idea.
So you're going to say, Joe, name that story arc?
Name that story arc.
All right, Joe, here are your 3 titles. Here are your 3 titles. Issue 1... Someone's been sleeping in our bed. Issue 2, Amidst the Stars. Number 3, Chase, Fight, Snicked.
Spoiler alert.
This one's almost unfair, but it's not. I'm very pleased that you said 13.
Okay. Can you go through the facts you gave again?
It's a 4-issue miniseries. Came out in 2009 into 2010. It's about a group of heroes who are replaced, and they are unhappy with their replacements. It revived and reintroduced characters long forgotten in this superhero universe, and it should have gotten more attention and credit. That's a personal opinion.
Editorializing here.
But it's a bit of a clue.
Wolverine and the X-Men, the 3-day weekend?
Close. Wolverine was in it. It's the X-Babies miniseries that I wrote. That should have gotten more credit and attention, because it's awesome. And I recommend everybody read it. In fact, the winner is getting a copy of X-Babies number 2, right here. You'll also be getting copies of 2 issues of G-Man. You'll be getting a collection of Evil Inc. comics by Mr. Brad Giger. and a pair of super puppet prints right there. Okay, so we get a point to Brad, because you challenged Joe. That's how it works. I should have said that at the beginning, shouldn't I?
Cool. So I got a point on it.
You got a point on that. Yeah. The challenger, if the person doesn't get it, the points work that way. So that was Maris who started us off. Joe, a number between 1 and 19, but not 13 and not 19.
1.
1. You guys love hugging the edges. All right. An 11-part storyline. Listed number 1 on the comic book resources top storylines of all time list. It's an 11-part story across 5 titles. 3 parts for 2 titles. Wait, what is it? 3 parts each for 2 titles, 2 parts for another, and 1 part in 2 more. A lot of books were involved in this storyline. The story involves a lot of death and physical harm. At least one character has changed dramatically, though that change has since been undone. Comics, everybody. Elements of this story have been affected by retcons 10 and 20 years after the initial telling. This was the first of what became a regular occurrence for a family of titles crossing over to tell a larger story. 31 credits across those 11 parts.
So my max is what? 11?
11.
Okay. Let's say 9.
9.
All right. Name it.
Whoa. Wow. All right. This may... If you know your stuff, you may... All right. It's title 1. Do anybody think they know it? Jay thinks he knows it. Title 1, The Morning After. Title 2, Spots. Title 3, Massacre. Title 4, Falling Angel. Okay. Title 5, Bloody Sunday. Title 6, The Gift of Death. Title 7, Whose Power? That had a question mark. Title 8, The Last Run. Title 9, The Fires of the Night. 11 parts across 5 titles. Started a trend for this family of titles. A lot of death and physical harm. A character changed dramatically and then returned to his original state.
Is it the Dark Phoenix Saga?
No, Dark Phoenix Saga is like 3 parts or 4 parts.
Hey.
What?
Curses. Don't insult him.
Oh, I'm giving the crowd the information that they need. Anybody else think they know it? To. Brad's getting the point, but anyone think they know it? Chris?
Is it Mutant Massacre?
It is Mutant Massacre. Indeed. Falling Angel and Massacre were some pretty good title clues. But it's okay, Joe. You were late.
All right. Oh, thank you.
Brad, 1 through 19, but not number 1, not number 13, and not number 19.
9.
I'm going to check what we're doing on time. What's the panel after this? Oh, no. Okay, 9. 19 parts over 3 titles. A 4th title had branding for the storyline, but they weren't numbered as part of the storyline. There was also an unmarked issue preceding it that is included in this list that I'm presenting to you. So there's 20 titles in the list. It features major changes to a lead character, including a costume. The main villain of the story has since taken on notoriety for more than just this story. And it was one of the first times I can remember a genuine awareness of how impermanent comic stories are. When I started reading it, I kind of knew, like, oh, this will get changed back eventually. It is tied at number 68 on the comic book resources list of great stories with Sins of the Father in Starman. 20 titles, 31 credits. Brad, what be your bid?
What's the highest I can go?
20.
15.
15.
14.
14. Jay?
And I can tell either one of them to name it.
No, you can tell Chris to name it.
Okay, yeah. Chris. Name it.
All right, Chris, here we go. Your titles are The Freedom of Madness, Crossed Eyes and Dotty T's, Red Slash, Puppets, Crocodile Tears, Night Terrors, Strange Dead Fellows, City on Fire, Burning Questions, Die Laughing, No Rest for the Wicked, The Broken Bat, Who Rules the Night, and Two-Face, colon, Double Cross.
Two-Face's colon was in that?
Two-Face's colon.
Weird.
Which is also split down the middle.
Yeah,
it's double-sided.
Weird.
Whoa, double-sided colon, nuts.
Is it colon wars?
Is that your actual guess?
No. Can I get the original clues again?
19-part crossover, but I have 20 here because there was an unmarked first part to it. There was a fourth title that had branding for the storyline, but those aren't considered in here. It is...
Is it Nightfall?
It is Nightfall.
Nice.
Nice.
Very good. I mean, the Broken Bat. That's that's a dead ringer.
That's how you play the game.
That's how you play the game. Chris, pick a number, 1 to 19, but none of the ones that we said before.
3.
All right. Where's number 3? Come on, papers. All right, number 3. 6 parts, number 30 on the Comic Book Resources Top 100 list. A self-contained miniseries with tie-in issues across the publisher's line, totaling 27 comics. I'm only going to list 6. It's a 6-part story. The main series gives you everything you needed. The original artist was unable to see the series all the way through. The series has a direct connection to my professional career, which I can explain afterwards. 6 credits, or 6 titles, 13 credits. It was pretty sweet. It was a pretty sweet 6-parter. I remember reading it when I was a young man.
I'll go 9.
All right, so you're saying 6.
I mean,
I'm sorry.
That's all right.
9.
Okay, we're going to flip that 9 upside down and make it a 6, Jay.
I'm going to say 5.
5, Maris.
I have no idea what it is, but I don't know. Do you want me to make you name it?
Go for it. That's how the game is played.
Name it.
All right,
please.
Jay.
Don't get it.
First title is God. Okay. Second title is From Bad to Worse. Preparations for War. Cosmic Battle on the Edge of the Universe. Astral Conflagration. Self-contained miniseries with tie-in issues across the publisher's line, totaling 27 comics beyond the main series. Main series gave everything they needed. The original artist unable to finish. Direct connection to my professional career. Yeah, how well do you know me?
That's what's throwing me.
How well does anybody know me, right? I'm so mysterious.
Who are you?
I know. Who am I? I'm Gregg Schigiel.
What was your first job in comics, Greg?
I can't say that out loud right now. This is key information. It was an issue of What If that had a direct tie-in to this storyline. It was a What If about this story. That's a bit of a clue. But that's a heavy clue.
That's an extra clue.
Mm-hmm. It is.
Yeah.
What do you say, Jay?
I know what character it involves. I just don't know the name of the miniseries for the thing. So.
Can I take a wild guess?
Take a shot.
Is it Infinity Gauntlet?
It is the Infinity
yes!
Gauntlet.
Yes!
Wow!
I'm sorry, I only like indie comics. Just kidding. No, that was a stab in the dark. It was all the astral stuff. But I just read that like a month ago.
As the challenger, you get the point anyway. So good on you.
Yeah, sorry. Nice. Sorry, I didn't mean to rub it in your face. I'm just really proud of myself right now. I came to comics late in the game. So
I just got hustled.
I know, I seriously.
All right, Jay, this is the last round of this, right? Because you started with Maris.
I started it. Didn't
you started it? I thought Maris started it.
No, because I picked...
You started. So did we do 5 already?
Yeah.
All right. Fantastic. The points now. Joe, you are... it's a good thing you did it in that round before, because you have nothing for this round. Maris, Jane, Chris all have 1 point. Brad has 2 points. Nice job, everybody. The next game is called Super... What is it called? Super Costume Celebrity, I think we call it. And this is where you guys come up and play. The way it's going to work is you're going to come up and stand next to me. I have... index cards with superheroes on them. You will describe the costume that the superhero is wearing to your partner. Nothing about the character's powers or what they do or their secret identities or storylines, just their costume stuff. And your partner will have to guess who you're describing. Let me see how much time we have. We got time. Everybody's going to get 90 seconds. And
Who describes? Do we describe the costume, or does our
your partner describes the costume? You guess. Okay. You guess who the partner is. So let me set the timer. So we'll start. We started that last one with you, Jay, right?
Yeah.
So we need Ian to come up. Can Ian come on up? How you doing, Ian?
Good.
How old are you?
Six.
Six? I was six once. Do you believe it?
You've been six several times.
It's true. Do you have a favorite superhero? Talk right into this thing.
Iron Man.
Iron Man. Why? What's the best thing about Iron Man?
Because I like his costume.
Perfect answer. Perfect answer, because this is a costume game. Look at that. The crowd loves you, man. Do you know how this game works? Do you understand it? You're going to describe what's on this card? You have black hair, yellow hair, blue pants, red shorts, five fingers.
Anything but the name, right?
Except for
anything Nitro. But the name. Now, here's what you can do. If you don't know what it is, or your partner can't get it, you can say pass, and we'll move to the next one. Got it? Can you pick one of these? This one? All right, here we go. Maris, are you ready?
I am ready.
All right. Ian, are you ready? I'm going to put them in front of you. You're going to have 90 seconds. I'll keep track of the time, and you just describe the costume as best you can. I'll help you out if you need help. Hold on. Wait till I say start. This is going to be your first one, okay? So into this microphone, describe that person.
He has horns on his head.
Is it Loki?
No.
What color is his head?
Blue.
Blue. And what color is his shirt?
Gray.
Gray.
Okay. Crazy.
Does he have something on his chest?
A bat.
He's got a bat on his chest.
Oh, is it Batman?
It is Batman.
Yes.
All right. Now, is that a man or a lady?
Lady.
It's a lady.
Okay.
What's on her head?
A hat.
What color is the hat?
Black.
Black hat. What is she holding in her hand?
A stick.
A stick.
It's a Zatanna.
It is.
Woo!
Good. All right. What does this guy look like?
A carrot.
He looks like a carrot.
Is it the flaming carrot?
It is.
Wow!
All right. Here, let's do this one. What color is his costume?
Black and white.
Black and white. And the white parts look kind of like what?
Flames.
Like flames and stars? Yep. It's a black and white costume, and the white parts look like they're sort of like starry, flamey sort of things.
Okay. Is it Wiccan?
It is not
Wiccan. Probably not Wiccan.
You want to pass? All right. We're going to pass. How do you want to describe that one? Oh, time's up.
Woo! Thank you, Ian.
Ian, you got 3 points. Did an amazing job. Chris, let's give this guy a G-Man comic anyway.
Yay, right, thanks, buddy. Ian.
Good? All right. So we get 3 points. We're giving 3 points to Maris. All right. Then we're going to Joe. Cheryl, come on up.
Together again.
Cheryl, you are also six? All right. Select one of these packs. Don't look at it yet, cheater. Hand that to me. I'm the host of this thing. All right, Joe, are you ready?
Sure.
Cheryl, are you ready?
Sure.
All right. We'll begin when I show you the first one. I'm going to give you a little bit less help.
Really?
Yeah, just a little. I'll still show them to you. Oh, hold on. Oh, you can look at it. Begin.
All right. Woman, she's got a golden lasso.
Wonder Woman.
All right. Oh, yeah, you got this.
Guy, he's got a lightning bolt on his chest. He wears a blue suit, yellow boots, a cape.
You can pass if you want, but it'll come back around.
All right, I'm gonna pass.
All right.
Okay. I can't give his name, can I?
You cannot give his name. You gotta describe the costume.
Okay. He's got a skull on his costume. It's all
Punisher?
Black.
Is
the Punisher? Yep.
All right.
Wait, not that one.
Oh.
Sorry. Okay, go.
Okay. He is. Jeez.
You can pass if you want.
No, I.
Yeah, I understand.
Okay, all right. He is dead. He's
costume stuff only.
Sorry.
It's all right.
All
Ghost
black.
Rider.
What?
No, Ghost not Rider. Ghost Rider.
He wears all black. It's a red cape.
Dead man.
He's got a M. Looks like skull. He's got skulls.
Oh, Mephisto.
No.
No.
These are all superheroes.
He's,
what are these things?
He's got a chain belt.
He's got chains all over. What's on his...
Spawn?
Yes.
Okay.
Sorry.
It's all right. You have 10 seconds.
Okay. All right. He's a guy. He has an A on his belt. Orange top, green bottom.
Aquaman?
Aquaman, yes. And that's time. Nice job, Carol. Thank you. That is 1, 2, 3, 4.
No.
The one you didn't get was Captain Marvel Jr.
Captain Marvel Jr.?
Yeah.
Okay.
He looks like this, Maris.
Oh. Thank you.
All
it
right.
Just looks like regular Captain Marvel with blue.
Right. Rowan.
That's a pretty sweet drawing. Who drew it?
Mike Norton. Huh? Yeah.
No, you drew.
I did not draw. Rowan, come on up. You're tall, right? You don't need this extra chair. Of course not. You are also 6, correct?
11.
Okay, so 6. Everybody's 6 today.
Yes.
Yes, it's Sunday.
I'll turn so we keep it fair.
Yeah, don't cheat, Brian Geiger. All right, you ready?
Yes.
You know how it works? You've been watching? You've been paying attention?
Yes.
All right. Time will start when I say go. And go.
It's a guy. He has a hammer. He has a red cape, wings on his helmet, blonde
Thor.
Hair.
Very good.
It's a girl. She has a spiked mallet, has wings, yellow top, green pants, red, orange boots.
Valkyrie?
Nope.
A spiked mallet?
Has a...
You can say pass if you want. We come back to it.
Pass.
Pass.
Guy looks like he has an afro, sort of.
Yeah. Luke Cage, Power Man.
Nope.
Has a, is that gray? Has
blue.
A bluish, yellow, blue costume with yellow electricity on
oh,
it.
Oh, Black Lightning.
Very good. This one's tricky, but he might know it.
All silver.
Shiny. Silver Surfer.
Nope.
Has a star on his chest. Off to one side, it's a guy.
Pass?
Pass.
Pass.
It's a guy. He has an red
costume,
outfit.
Yeah.
Orange cape, orange gloves, orange boots. What is that sign?
That is an atomic symbol on his forehead.
He has an atomic symbol on his forehead. He has
Firestorm.
No.
He has what looks like an electric lightning strike going up out of his.
Off the top of his head.
Off the top of his head.
Oh. There's Radioactive Man.
Oh. The Simpsons. Oh, yeah.
Nice.
Okay, who was?
Nice job, Larry. It was Hawk Girl. Hawk Girl was the winged
spiked
character.
Mallet.
The spiked mallet. And the silver guy was Martinex from the Guardians of the Galaxy.
Oh, that's
who
true.
Looks like
wow.
He's made of. 4 minutes? All right. 4 minutes. Rowan gets 2 points. I need Ray. Get up here. Quick. You got 4 minutes. Quick, quick, quick. Take a card back.
6 years old.
You're six, right?
Is that a man or a lady?
All right. Don't start until I say go. Look at you. You are on point, man. Ready? You can look at it. I'm just saying don't start saying anything. Go.
Okay, she's got a wimple. She's all in her. She's got long, kind of brownish hair.
Is it wimple?
That's what you call that thing. Yeah. It's a. Yeah, she's got a red cape. She's got kind of gauntlet style red gloves, and she's got kind of red unitard, kind of bathing suit kind of thing, and kind of a pinkish red body stocking under it.
Scarlet Witch.
Yeah, very good.
Very good.
He's got a shield and wings on his head.
Captain America.
He's black and he has a red bird perched on him.
Falcon.
He has a yellow cape, a white bodysuit. He's got red wristbands with yellow buttons on them. And he's got a little red triangle on his chest with the outline of a ghost on it.
Space ghost.
I'll give it to you, but that's freaky.
He's got a black and yellow costume with a stinging insect on his chest.
Yellow jacket.
That's better.
She's got a red and white costume with a planet that's further away from the sun than Jupiter on her chest.
Neptune girl?
No, you cannot say the name of the planet.
Is it Neptune girl? Pluto girl? Something girl? Pass!
Time's up. Saturn girl.
Who else was there?
Come on up. Go, you go. Ready? Go.
This guy uses katanas, black and red suit, red striped on the side. He's hooded, big black eyes, white center, red hood. Kind of ninja-like, utility belt. Sometimes carries tons of guns.
Deadpool.
Yes.
Yes.
She is a. Generally wears a bomber jacket, green and yellow suit underneath,
Rogue.
Spandex.
Yep.
Blue cape, stars beneath it, kind of a cross on his chest, blue and red suit, gauntlets, golden gauntlets, long blonde mane of hair. We're going to pass that one. Green suit, yellow cape, red face.
Vision.
Yep. Green skin, purple pants.
Hulk.
Yellow or pink suit, short cape. No pants. Atomic symbol with a female symbol underneath it. Tiny pink cape, red hair, big gaudy pink earrings.
Oh, Adam Eve.
Very good.
Has a vegetable down his chest. Yellow suit, red cape, green shorts.
Also, Captain Carrot?
Yes.
Wow.
Yellow or white and red suit. We're gonna pass on
that one.
Oh, we're gonna pass on that one.
Oh.
I don't even know some of these.
All right, that means time's up. You tally up your points. This Quasar was the one you didn't get.
Quasar.
Okay. You set it down. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Matt, you win. You get the prize. Hey. 12 points total. Don't go anywhere. I'm going to give you your prizes. Thank you all. We're out of time. Thank the panel. Even the late ones. Thank you all for coming. Good night, America.
If anybody would like a complimentary copy of G-Man, come on up.
If you want to check out Marissa's super doodle she's been doing the whole time.
I have one for Ian, so.
We did our best.
Thank you.
Yeah. Ian's the little guy with the hat over there.
I was hoping someone would get it when G came around.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, I do need you once you are complete up here to clear the room as quickly as possible. We have a very large panel that needs to seat in here. All right, and there should be 13 people that we told could stay in here.
Yeah. Thank you. Oh, thank you.
Thank you, guys.
It was fun. Yeah. It's always fun. Yeah. It's all about having fun up in this piece.
It all up when I get back to my